Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how to find the largest files on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a fantastic group of supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content. So there are a lot of reasons you may want to search for the largest files on your Mac. Maybe you need to quickly free up some space, and you figure the best way to do that is to find a couple big files you don't need and delete them. Maybe you want to do some spring cleaning and you figure the largest files are the best place to start. Or maybe you're just having a contest with a friend to see who has the largest files on their Mac. Who am I to judge? So there are two methods you could use. One is to just look in the Finder. You could do a Finder search by file size and then sort to see which files are the largest. But for typical Mac users, it's probably best to use a special system utility. I'm going to show you both methods. To find your largest files using the Finder, first it's a good idea to create a new Finder window. That way you could size it for what you want. So make it pretty much fill the screen because you're going to need a lot of space. Then go to File, Find, or just use Command F. And then you can ignore the search box up here and go directly to the modifications right there, the criteria for the search. Change kind to file size. Change equals to is greater than. And then enter a pretty large number here. So as an example, I'll do 100 and then megabytes. And this will show me files that are larger than 100 megabytes. Now, I want to change the search domain or the search area. It'll be the current folder that you were looking at, but you want to change it to this Mac. And that's going to show you all the files on the Mac that are greater than 100 megabytes. The next thing you want to do is you want to make sure you click on size here. So make sure it's sorted by size. Make sure you see this little arrow pointing down here. If you see it pointing up, simply click it again to make sure that the largest files are at the top. And then you'll see the sizes. If you don't see a size column here, you could shrink these columns like that to make more room. And you can also do View, Show View Options, and you'll have different columns you can choose here. So make sure size is selected so it appears there. So now with this sorted by size, I see the largest files at the top. Now it's not as useful as you would think because I'm looking at the entire Mac. I'm going to see system files, library files, all sorts of things in here that I may not want to be mixed in with the documents I actually want to find. So it's actually better to look in some specific places. There are going to be four places that you should check. So use the Go menu and go Home. Home is going to be where you're going to have your documents and desktop folder if you're not using iCloud Drive. But even if you are using iCloud Drive, you're still going to find things like movies, music, pictures, downloads, and some other things that would be on your local drive, not stored in iCloud Drive. So if you do the same search here, I'm going to do Command F, file size greater than 100 megs. This will show me what I've got in my home folder. And here I get something very useful. I see I do indeed have a lot stored in Final Cut Pro and iMovie. So of course those are video files. It makes sense. I'm using a lot of space there. Here's something pretty big and I can tell it's in my downloads folder. If I look down here at the bottom, I can see the path to it. And here's a video file that's taking up some space as well. So that's the first place to look. Second place to look is if you are using iCloud Drive, use Go iCloud Drive and do the same search here. Command F, file size greater than 100 megabytes. And this will show me anything I had there. Now, if you don't find anything that's this size, you may want to shrink the size a bit. Like at 10 megabytes, I do find several things that are larger than 10 megs. The third location is Go and then Applications. And then if you do that search here, then you'll find any apps that are taking up more than 100 megabytes. And you'll have them sorted so I can see which apps are pretty big. If you see an app here you want to get rid of, note that you shouldn't do anything here. What you should do is go to Launchpad and then click and hold an app to get the little X's there and uninstall it that way. Or if it's an app from a third-party developer, make sure you use their official uninstall method. And the last place I want you to look is your user library folder. Now if you use the Go menu, you're not going to see it here unless you hold down the Option key and then it appears. And then you can go to your library, do the same search here, and it's going to be hard to interpret what's here, but sometimes the path can give you a clue. So I click on this file here and I see it's Library Application Support Mobile Sync Backup. Ah, okay. So these are iPhone and iPad backups. I'm going to show you a better way to look at these in a minute. Then you may see some other files. If I shrink to 10 megabytes, for instance, you may see this, for instance. And you look at the path Library Application Support Google Chrome. Oh, okay. It's actually part of Chrome. So if you see a lot of things there that are part of application support for an app, you may want to consider getting rid of that app if you don't use that app. Now let's look at a better way for typical Mac users to find large files. Go to the Apple menu and About This Mac. Now go to Storage. And then click on Manage. And here you can get all these categories on the left. It may take a few minutes for the spinners to stop after calculations are done. If you look at applications, you get a really quick good list of the apps that you have and how much size they're using. You can also select one and then choose to delete it, although I would recommend using the official uninstall method, either Launchpad or for an app like this, an Adobe app, there's a way to uninstall through Adobe. I wouldn't just delete it here. Now, documents you think would show you your documents folder, but actually it shows you more than that. It shows you everything in your user folder. For instance, this is in the movies folder here. So it's showing you all of your stuff and there's a delete button there as well. So this is a great way if you see like, oh, here's something in downloads I don't need anymore, to just delete it. And if you want to jump to that folder in the Finder, you can use this Show in Finder button here. Now this method shows you two locations that could be taking up a lot of space in your hard drive that are hard to see otherwise. The first is iOS files. And I talked about backups a minute ago. So here I've got three backups. These are really old backups because this is a demo account. But let's say this is an old iPhone and this is my current iPhone. I may not realize that I still have a backup for my old iPhone there. I can actually select that and use this delete button here to get rid of it. That could save a lot of space. And you saw all those files that showed up in your library folder before. They all may be too small together to show up, but the backup itself here may be pretty big. So the only way you're going to find and be able to delete these backups is going in here. Another place to look is music creation. And what you're going to get here is a total size for GarageBand and maybe some other apps, like if you have Logic installed. A lot of people don't realize how much space all the music samples for these apps take up. So if you just downloaded GarageBand to play around with it but you don't really use it and you're desperate to get back hard drive space, you may want to consider using this button here to remove the GarageBand sound library. And then of course you could also go to Launchpad and delete GarageBand completely. That'll give you back a lot of space as that's a pretty big app. You also see down here other users, which isn't something you can act on here, but it is a good reminder that if you can't find large files, it may be that you don't have them in your user account. That there's another user, whether it's another family member or another user account you created for some purpose, that may be taking up a lot of space. And in that case, you would have to log in as them or have that person log in their user account and maybe do some cleaning in there. So when you find those large files, you may not just want to delete them. You may want to keep them around even if you don't need to use them all the time. A technique a lot of Mac users like myself use is to archive them. And that's to get an external drive and then copy those files to an external drive, delete the originals on your Mac, and then know that you can always go back to that external drive if you need to get access to those files again. This is especially useful if you create project-based work, like if you create videos or music and you have this project and you finished with it, but you don't want to delete it, but you're probably not going to be going back to it anytime soon. You can then archive that project to an external drive so you still have it around, but you free up that space on your internal drive to use for other things. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.